This is the foreign minister of Sweden.
I know that.
And this is Uma Thurman.
I know that too.
you're here with a new solo album, which is not a solo album at all, because you have this collaboration with Miles Kennedy.
Yeah.
The singer.
Well, it started out, you know, just a simple thing where he and I met, and you know, had a certain kind of chemistry, and we went on the road together, and it just became this. Really, you know, also our drummer and bass player, Brent Fitz and Todd Kearns, and we just started jamming and doing shows, and it just turned out to be what started out as just a throw-together project turned into something that was really, really good. So we've done two albums. This is our second one.
Is the atmosphere touring these days compared to the old days? Is the atmosphere different?
Let's see. I mean, it doesn't really change that much. I mean, it's all about the gigs, and there's chaos at the shows always, so that hasn't changed much. How I handle gigs is maybe a wee bit different than it was 20 years ago, but, yeah.
What is the main difference?
I'm sober, so that's... that's probably the biggest change, you know?
So, I mean, you will be 50 next year.
Mm-hmm. I just turned 49, so let's not push it.
And this is actually it's miraculous. I mean, given the life that you led.
I'm pretty fortunate, all things considered, because I've you know been pretty close to, you know, I shouldn't be here, so I'm pretty lucky.
Being a father now, you have two kids.
Two, yeah.
How can you? not be a role model, in this sense. What kind of advice do you give them? Because probably you don't want them to live your life.
No, but I don't think they want to anyway. You know, all things considered, they do their own thing, and you know, I'm a pretty hard work, you know, pretty diligent worker, and so I set a pretty good example as far as work ethic goes, and I don't have any really bad habits at this point in time for them to be observing. So, you know, all things considered, it's a little bit unorthodox sort of surroundings that they're raised in, but we love them to death and we take good care of them.
Then they have they're called Cash and London.
Yeah, I didn't know what you were going to say just now. Yeah, Cash and London.
And it's easy to love both Cash and London. I mean, it's. Yeah. I don't know how it's for you. I mean, you called Uma yourself.
I am, actually.
And for your daughter, your youngest daughter, you chose a very, very long name. I can't.
That was sort of an accident. It's a long story.
But it's not as quite. It's a long name. It's a long name.
It is. I can't even repeat it myself. But we could just call her Luna.
Yes, but it's like five names.
Yes, I know. But that's. It's very
complicated. I'm dying to hear it now.
why did you give her so many names?
Well, her father wanted her to have lots of names.
So you just
life's too short. Life is shorter than her name.
It'd be great in school, though. So I'm not answering to that one today. I'm answering to this one. You know?
And Your wife, she's called Perla.
Yeah.
She's been with you all the time through these hard times.
18 years.
What part did she play when you got out of what you were in?
Well, my wife's a pretty tough gal, and she's just, you know, she knew what she was getting into when she first hooked up with me, so. She's just been tenacious enough to hang in there, and you know, she's always had my back. So when I've taken things a little bit too far over the edge, she's always been there. You know?
Well, they actually overlap. So Neanderthals are our very closest relatives. They are like 10 times closer to us than chimpanzees are.